हाय व्यूअर्स,
वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल अगेन। तो होप इन पैरेलल लाइंस चैप्टर यू हैव नो प्रॉब्लम विद दैट। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर। द चैप्टर नेम इज सर्कल्स, ओके, एंड वी आर फॉलोइंग आरएस अग्रवाल मैथ बुक। चैप्टर नेम इज सर्कल्स फ्रॉम ज्योमेट्री। From geometry. Now, as we can see that there are various types of shapes in our daily life. We can see now circles. Okay, so since we have done the circles in mensuration, this things is slightly different from that mensuration chapter. Circle means the definition is given here, but before that we have seen a coin. Okay, a coin or an earring. An earring, okay, or a tire, okay. So these are the shapes. These are those the shape of circles. Understood that? Means if we take a point, okay, and by taking this point as center. If we are considering some points, that are equidistant from this center, okay, then if we join that points, the figure which we got, that is called circle. Understood that? Now here the definition is given. The definition is, I am just reading it. You can easily understand that a circle is the collection of all those points in a plane whose distance from a fixed point remains constant. Okay, that means the distance remained constant. Constant means unchanged. That means the distance from this, if we take this point as O, the distance between this distance, all are remaining same. That is, if this distance is 2 unit, then this is also 2 unit. All of this are 2 units. Okay, so the distance remains same. So it is called a circle. Understood that? So now in a circle, if we take a circle here, this is a circle, this is the interior point or the center. In a circle, this distance, the distance between this is called circumference of a circle. You have already read that. This is called circumference and this is called the center. Now the distance between this center and circumference, that is called radius. This is called radius R. Radius, this is equal to distance between radius. Distance between center and circumference. Understood that? This is distance between center and circumference of a circle. Next, move to the interior and exterior of a circle. Interior and exterior of circle. What is interior and what is exterior? If we take a circle like that, we are taking a circle. This is a circle. So the inner points or the inner region that are present inside the circumference, this is called the interior. interior, and the outer point, these points are called the exterior. Interior and exterior, understood that? Next, come to diameter of a circle. You know about diameter. Again, I am telling you, the diameter is, if we join two points of the circle that passes through the center of the circle, that is called diameter. So this is diameter. This is diameter. Okay, and half of a length, that is called the radius. So diameter is equal to 2 into radius, if we represent it as r. Understood that? Next, move to chord of a circle. What is a chord? If we take one circle like that, okay, suppose if we take a circle, this is a circle. What is a chord? A chord is any two point of a circumference which joins each other but not going through the center. Okay, that is called chord. Now, a diameter is also a chord. That is the biggest chord for a circle. Understood that? Next, secant of a circle. So this is a chord. This is the chord. Next, come to secant. Secant of a circle. What is secant? If a line is drawn through a circle, that is called secant. So this is called a secant. This is secant. Understood that? Next, this is the center row. Next, move to circumference of a circle. The perimeter of a circle is called the circumference. You know that. This is called circumference. This is called circumference. Next, segment of a circle. What is a segment? If we take a circle like that, suppose we are taking a circle like that. Okay, now we are taking one chord. So these regions are called segment of a circle. Understood that? This is a smaller, bigger region, so it is called major segment. The smaller region is called minor segment. Understood that? Next, move to semicircle. If we cut a circle along its diameter, which figure we have got, that is called the semicircle. That is, suppose we have a circle like that, we are cutting to along its diameter, so we are getting like two figures. This is the first figure and this is the second figure. So this each are called the semicircle. Understood that? These are called the semicircle. And these regions are called semicircular region. Okay. This semicircular region, this is also semicircular region. Next, move to arc of a circle. Now, any part of a circle is called an arc of a circle. Any part of a circle, as the definition is given in book, any part of a circle, any part of circumference or perimeter of a circle, that is called the arc of a circle. That is, suppose we are taking a circle like that, any part, this is the one part, okay. Now, if we cut into this, so we are getting this. So this is called arc of the circle. Understood that? Next, come to sector of a circle. Sector. Sector of a circle. Suppose we are taking one circle like that. This is one circle. Okay. And this is a point. Suppose we are dividing it by two radius. Taking two radius. So these are called the sector. Okay. Since this is bigger, so it is called the major sector, and this is smaller, so it is minor sector. So this is minor and this is major. Both are sector. Major sector and minor sector. Okay, hope you understand that. Here the definition is given, I am just reading it. The area bounded by an arc and two radii joining the endpoints of the arc with the center is called a sector. Go through the definition from R.S. Agarwal math book. Okay. R.S. Agarwal math book. Okay. Next come to concentric circle. Concentric. Concentric circle. If two or more circles have the same center but different radius, then the circles are called concentric circle. Okay. This is one circle. This is another circle. This is another. They have same center but different radius. This is one radius. This is another radius. Understood that? So these three circles are concentric circles. So there are infinite number of concentric circles. Okay. If we have to draw. So that's it for today's class or today's topic, whatever you say. Next, here the exercise is given of circle EX18 of R.S. Agarwal, obviously R.S. Agarwal math book, EX18, page number in my book 207, in my book. So I suggest you that you should start the exercise, that is your today's classwork and homework, whatever you say. Understood that? Now, if you have any problem regarding the exercise 18 of R.S. Agarwal math book, so you can ask me in your WhatsApp study group. Now, so that is today's class. Now, since you have already notified or noticed that your periodic test is coming on after your vacation, study leave or vacation, whatever you say. So the periodic test syllabus, okay, the syllabus that is given in your math syllabus together, that is your periodic test syllabus. Okay, so I am already told you that your periodic test syllabus that is given in your along with your syllabus, that is your periodic test syllabus. Okay, 25 marks question should be coming out from that side. So be ready to give your periodic test. And again, I am telling you that stay with us, stay with me, and please do subscribe my channel for getting more math related video of different types. And that's it for today's class. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.